Bum bum ba-dum bum 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 ba-dum bum 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 ba-dum ba-dum bum bum ba-dum bum bum. I would just like to apologize to all of your eardrums for that, but I couldn't resist. What's up, Star Readers? It's Warren, and today I am back with a new video, repping my Team USA gear for the Winter Olympics, of course. Sorry, guys, that I've been gone for a couple weeks, not really making a bookish video. I've just been really busy. Life's busy, man. But I'm back now, and I decided for today's video, I'm going to combine my January wrap-up and my February TBR and put them together because I don't think I read enough books in January to make an entire video out of. It would just be a big waste of time because I didn't read that much in January, so I'm going to just combine it all together. And also, something I wanted to talk about real quick before we get started is it has been brought to my attention by some people who have commented maybe not very nice things on my channel that I tend to talk a lot about the same books in multiple videos, and I admit that I do that a lot. Really, the main reason is because, I mean, those are my favorite books, and I'm going to talk about my favorite books on this channel. Like, that's the whole point. And I only have so many books on my bookshelf. It's not like I have this entire library of 7,000 books, you know, like the elite booktubers do. So I just talk about what I have. But I do realize that sometimes I talk about books repetitively and it can just get old sometimes because you've probably heard the same thing before. I'm trying to not do that as often, but I can't always just buy new books every single week. So I have something to talk about. Anyways, that being said, I read 3 books in the month of January. And for the wrap up portion of this video, the books that I read, I have talked about at length in multiple videos on this channel. You guys know these books. So I'm not going to go into detail about it all because I just feel like it's a waste of breath. I'm just gonna give you guys a quick log line about what the book's about, what I thought about it, and just a rating. Just a real quick summation because I don't feel like spending all my time reviewing a book for my wrap up. And then I'm going to skip into the February TBR part, which is going to be super fun. So with all that being said, here are the books that I read for the month of January 2018. The first book to kick off 2018 with was The Assassin's Blade by Sarah J. Maas. And you guys know I've talked about this book a lot. These are the prequel novellas that take place before the first book, Throne of Glass. And I rated this book 5 stars because I loved it. I have yet to read a Sarah J. Maas book, knock on wood, that has fallen under 5 stars in quality. I just really enjoyed reading the different novellas and just getting to see some of Selena's backstory and to learn about what she was doing before the events of the first book. So it was really good. It got me excited to continue with this series. After reading this, I just think even more of Selena and her character just being so badass. So I really loved this book. It was a great strong start to the reading year. The second book of 2018, which is also the second book I read in January, was Illuminae by Jay Kristoff and Amy Kaufman. And I went into deep detail about this book in my sci-fi reads video. So if you want to check that out, the link's in the title card up there. This is an epic sci-fi thriller taking place in space aboard a starship called the Alexander. And it follows 2 characters named Katie and Ezra. I just loved this book. I gave this one 5 out of 5 stars as well because it was so good. And just the way it was written in this dossier format was awesome. Could not put it down. I loved it. It was so emotional and exciting and mysterious. Everything I wanted in a space novel. The third book I read in January was An Enchantment of Ravens by Margaret Rogerson. And this book is very interesting. There's been a lot of kind of mixed opinions about this book. I have not posted my rating and review yet on Goodreads because I haven't updated my Goodreads in a while. But I think I'm going to rate this book 3 stars because it was good, but it wasn't great and it wasn't bad. So it was your average fantasy book. It's very similar to A Court of Thorns and Roses. And sometimes that was good and other times it's a little bit predictable, which made it not as interesting. The biggest controversy surrounding this book is the romance plot is said to be a little bit of insta-love. And I understand where those the people that are saying that are coming from. It didn't bother me too much, but it did take away a little bit of the anticipation in the plot. Like, it didn't make or break the book for me. I just didn't really think it was a good writing choice. But besides that, this is a very interesting book. It takes a lot of inspiration from the Welsh and Scottish lore about fae and fair folk, and it reminds me a lot of A Court of Thorns and Roses. And I do think that the title, An Enchantment of Ravens, is clever because it references something in the plot. So I think that was kind of cool. It was a great way to name the book. Now we're gonna move on to my February TBR. I know it's already the middle of February and I'm just now getting around to posting this video, but I've been a little busy. My February TBR is, as usual, very ambitious, but there are 3 books in this TBR that I want to focus on the most. I don't really care if I get around to reading the other books or not. So it is close to Valentine's Day and I get to be reminded once again how single and alone I am and probably will remain to be. So I decided I would spend Valentine's Day reading To All the Boys I Love
Before by Jenny Han. And I have yet to pick up this series, and I know it's becoming a movie, so I want to read this book series before the movie comes out, and just because it's perfect for the Valentine's season. This is just a super short contemporary about a girl, Lara Jean, and she writes all these love letters to her crushes that she's liked in high school, and she never meant to show them to anybody. They're just kind of her personal way to vent her feelings, and then one day they accidentally go public, and now all the boys that she's loved and had crushes on read these letters, and it kind of becomes a little bit of a drama situation. Sounds funny, and I think it'll be a perfect read for Valentine's Day. The next book I'm really excited to read this month is Warcross by Marie Lu, and I have heard really good things about this book, and I love the cover and how it's cool. It's like all these rainbow colors. This book is basically like Tron, War Games, and Ready Player One all combined into a cyber novel, and I'm really excited to read this, especially because Ready Player One is becoming a movie this year, so I think this will be really appropriate. So this follows a girl named Mika, who is a really talented hacker, and she's hacking into this like MMORPG, which is stands for, I think, Massive Multiplayer Online Role-Playing Game. It's a mouthful. She basically hacks into this game, and it's against the rules, it's legal, and there's a mystery and kind of a plot about this game. And so she gets a call from the game's creator, who wants to recruit her to be a hacker to catch another hacker that's in the game. I think it's kind of a cool story. I don't really know that much about it, so I don't know if that's exactly accurate for the plot. I try to look at the synopsis between cuts. That's what I think the plot's about. Anyways, it sounds really cool, and I think the cover is very simplistic and artistic. Continuing in the sci-fi genre, I'm also going to pick up Nixia by Scott Rankin, and this book is about a guy named Emmett, who is a teenager from kind of a rough living situation, and he's recruited to be an astronaut on board a starship that is going to interstellar space to a foreign planet. It's a little bit of an experimental program because he's put on board a starship with a bunch of other angsty young people who come from rough living situations, and there is a competition involved somehow, so it's kind of like Ender's Game, I guess. It sounds pretty unique and cool, and I love me a good space novel, of course. The next book that I really want to get into this month if possible is The Cruel Prince by Holly Black. I've heard so many good things about this book. It's just been hyped up, and it's another Fae-related story. I have Holly Black's The Darkest Part of the Forest, but I'm not sure if this is going to be urban fantasy like that, or if it's going to be more mystical and fantasy, but I've heard it's really good, and I want to pick it up. Also, the cover looks so cool, and it looks like it'll be great to put in my Bookstagram photos. The next book is a classic that I have yet to read, and that is The Picture of Dorian Gray by Oscar Wilde. Now, there's a reason that I'm picking this book up this month. I've decided that I want to start a Goodreads book club, where each month of the remaining 11 months of this year, we read a different classic, and we all discuss it in a Goodreads group. I just really love classics. I think it's important that we read classics, just appreciate artwork of its day, because I guarantee you, a classic that was published in like 1870 would not be published today. They just wouldn't get through publishing today. So I think it's kind of important to appreciate them because they're almost special in a way. And Barnes & Noble, of course, makes the most beautiful leather-bound classic books that I have ever read. So if you're interested in joining my Goodreads book club, I'll put a link below for the group. And yeah, we're gonna just pick a classic to read each month. We'll have a vote. I'd love for you to be part of this group. This month, we're going to be reading The Picture of Dorian Gray. And the last book that I want to probably put the most emphasis and focus on this month is, of course, Queen of Shadows by Sarah J. Maas. This is the next book in the Throne of Glass series, and I have yet to read this one. I've only read up to Air of Fire. I've already complained about how much I've been spoiled for this series already, so do not even think about mentioning spoilers. This just continues the story of Selaena Sardothian and her conflicts in the Kingdom of Adarlan. After reading Air of Fire, I was so hyped up, and I wish I didn't wait so long to pick this book up, but I think February is as good a month as any to pick this book up and devour it. Hopefully I will get around to reading this book. This is probably the one I'm going to put the most time on because it's a huge brick. So those are all of the books that I want to read this month, February. Hopefully I'll get around to all of them if I can, but the main three that I want to get to is Queen of Shadows, Cruel Prince, and The Picture of Dorian Gray. So we shall see. But yeah, that's all I have for you guys today. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope you all enjoyed. As always, don't forget to like and subscribe. Comment down below and tell me two things. One, what books are you reading for February this year? And which Winter Olympic team are you cheering for this year? I'm assuming it would be the team of your country, so you know, what country are you cheering for? And yeah, I will see you all in my next video. Bye!